your security man? What have you given to your security man? What are you giving today to the person, the one who has been protecting you all this while? This businessman looked at the daughter and he was like, yeah, but one more day, Sikabe be a security man, or the day and ever. Yes. This security man had this sad event. So the next day, he decided to take a friend's leave. He decided to stop the work. There was this robber living nearby. Every time he would come and try to enter this businessman's house, but when he sees the security man with a gun, he will back off. This very day, he came, there was no security man, the door was open ajar, he entered. In an attempt to rob this businessman, he killed him. There is it. What are we giving to the person who have been protecting us throughout these 3 years? Today, if there was a God responsible for protection and a God responsible for wealth, we will be worshipping the God who gives us wealth. We will be worshipping the God who gives us riches. No one, even if some people choose to worship this God who protects us, there will be very few, because we will all be chasing wealth. We will all be chasing riches. There was this donkey who was tied up at a refuse dump. One day Jesus was trying to visit Jerusalem. He ordered his disciples to go in and fetch him this donkey. When this donkey was brought from the refuse dump, they covered him with rich clothing. While Jesus was seated at his back and was about entering to Jerusalem, people were throwing their gold, people were throwing out their silver, people were laying expensive clothing on the ground just for this donkey to step on. This donkey thought people are praising him because he was so good, because he was so handsome, because he knows how to walk, because he was, I don't know what to add. So after Jesus had ascended to heaven, this donkey one day at home realized he had to go back to Jerusalem and receive his fans. So he went to Jerusalem, walked through the whole town the whole day. No one came out to praise this donkey. This donkey became too furious. He went to the information center and announced, "People of Jerusalem, people of Jerusalem, I have come, the very donkey you are so praised the other time. Come and give me fans. Come and throw your silver to the ground. Come and spread your expensive clothing so that I can walk majestically upon." But no one came. This donkey went back to his mother, very sad. "Daddy V," the mother asked, "little dear, why are you so worried?" He simply replied, "I have gone to Jerusalem with Jesus. People had adored me so much. They were throwing their expensive gadgets on the floor for me to step on. Today I went there and it seems no one is recognizing me. They have refused to give me praises." The mother laughed and told this donkey, "Donkey, who did you say you went to Jerusalem with the other time?" And replied, "Jesus." Then the mother told him, "Then the fans that we were taking did not belong to you, but it surely belonged to Jesus." Most of us here, like donkey, believe that we are strong. We wake up in the morning, we kick and kick and kick and kick, and we think it's because of how we are taking good care of ourselves, because of the kind of food we are eating, because of the kind of bath we are bathing every day, because of the kind of clothing, the kind of PGMs we put on every day. But no, it is because of Jesus. So if our 3 years cycle is over and we are leaving, then we have our cause to praise Jesus. We have to praise him because he alone is our security man. He is guiding us throughout our stay here. So this evening, are gathering here, which is shared purposely for praising his holy name, must be honored. He must accept our full praises, for he alone deserves it.